We are fortunate to have with us this evening last month's winner of the Trip of the Month contest, Mr. Carl Kanker, who has recently returned from his prize-winning pleasure trip to darkest Africa. Mr. Carl Kanker.
Hula, la, ba, ba, America. Hula, ba, la, la, Africa. Hello, America. Hello, America. Africa says hello. I just got from Africa, and I want to take this opportunity to thank all of you who are responsible for my being sent to the Congo. Your generous donations far exceeded anything my late wife or I anticipated. And the only way I know of really showing my thanks for those four swell days is to share with you some of the highlights of our trip.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be all right. One of them cobra snakes struck me right between the eyes. You know how that feels. The doctor wanted me to let him take a look at it, but I'm set on finishing this tour. So I've just been taking aspirins and doping a little. There are several approaches to the jungle. My wife and I tried them all, but we found being dropped from a plane the most satisfactory. Although our guide had trouble with his parachute and jumping and broke both his ankles. But guides are a dime a dozen down there. And we got us another guide right away. The safari was there already waiting for us, and we jumped. And they all began yelling and throwing flowers and fruit at us. It made you feel warm all over. After an hour or so of this tomfoolery, we hit out on the trail. Our destination for that first day was the source of the Nile, the longest, and I might add, the dirtiest river in the world. Oh, but it was stinking. Our pack mules would fall down and play dead when it came time to water. It gets dark fairly early in the jungle. We pitch camp about a quarter after four. In spite of the stench, I slept like a top. That jungle air is wonderful for sleeping. So you want to take along plenty of blankets and guns. The next morning is one of those mornings when you hear the screech of the orangutan, the roar of the lion, and the trees were full of beautifully colored birds and snakes. Rembrandt couldn't have captured that beauty. It's one of those mornings you feel like just running around barefoot. But we had only been traveling on the trail about 4 or 5 hours, and my wife began to complain of her feet. The only shoes she had with her were those high-heeled sling pumps. No, she just couldn't take it. So we had to leave her there. A couple of days later, on the way back, I found this piece of her dress, along with her purse and gloves. And to this day, I don't know what happened to her. But what I really remember about that day was, it was the only day it didn't rain. And I got to take some dandy snapshots. They're not quite as large as I'd like to have them, but I lost the negatives when I was washed over a waterfall. Yeah. Now, I suppose you people here on the main floor are the only ones that can see these. Sorry, I didn't know there was a balcony in this auditorium. I'm just used to talking in churches or wherever they'll have me. I'm sorry, as you can see, this first picture's a little blurred. But while I was taking the picture, I got pretty badly gored by a rhinoceros. That laid me up for a couple of days. Luckily, though, two women missionaries pulled me through that scrape. I guess they'd gotten gored once or twice themselves, so I suppose they knew what to do. This next picture is of a friendly native tribe. There aren't too many friendly tribes in Africa. In fact, this is the only one our bunch ran into. Most of them get a little out of hand when you run out of trinkets for them. Especially them head shrinkers. See, they really become sassy. Wanna keep your hat on when you talk to them. Say, I can see my time's running out here. What I've tried to do is tell and show you some of the things about Africa that aren't in the travel folders. It isn't the nicest place in the world. No, wait a minute, I won't say that. I'll say this. I don't believe I'd recommend it for the whole family. If the children don't hunt, there really isn't too much for them.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are fortunate to have with us this evening last month's winner of the Trip of the Month contest, Mr. Carl Kanker, who has recently returned from his prize-winning pleasure trip to darkest Africa. Mr. Carl Kanker.
Hula, la, ba, ba, America. Hula, ba, la, la, Africa. Hello, America. Hello, America. Africa says hello. I just got from Africa, and I want to take this opportunity to thank all of you who are responsible for my being sent to the Congo. Your generous donations far exceeded anything my late wife or I anticipated. And the only way I know of really showing my thanks for those four swell days is to share with you some of the highlights of our trip. But we had only been traveling on the trail about 4 or 5 hours, and my wife began to complain of her feet. The only shoes she had with her were those high-heeled sling pumps. No, she just couldn't take it. So we had to leave her there. A couple of days later, on the way back, I found this piece of her dress, along with her purse and gloves. And to this day, I don't know what happened to her. But what I really remember about that day was, it was the only day it didn't rain. And I got to take some dandy snapshots. They're not quite as large as I'd like to have them, but I lost the negatives when I was washed over a waterfall. Yeah. Now, I suppose you people here on the main floor are the only ones that can see these. Sorry, I didn't know there was a balcony in this auditorium. I'm just used to talking in churches or wherever they'll have me. Trip.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be all right. One of them cobra snakes struck me right between the eyes. You know how that feels. The doctor wanted me to let him take a look at it, but I'm set on finishing this tour. So I've just been taking aspirins and doping a little. There are several approaches to the jungle. My wife and I tried them all. But we found being dropped from a plane the most satisfactory. Although our guide had trouble with his parachute and jumping and broke both his ankles. But guides are a dime a dozen down there. And we got us another guide right away. The safari was there already waiting for us, and we jumped. And they all began yelling and throwing flowers and fruit at us. It made you feel warm all over. After an hour or so of this tomfoolery, we hit out on the trail. Our destination for that first day was the source of the Nile, the longest, and I might add, the dirtiest river in the world. Oh, but it was stable. Our pack mules would fall down and play dead when it came time to water. It gets dark fairly early in the jungle. We pitch camp about 4:15. In spite of the stench, I slept like a top. That jungle air is wonderful for sleeping. So you want to take along plenty of blankets and guns. The next morning is one of those mornings when you hear the screech of the orangutan, the roar of the lion, and the trees were full of beautifully colored birds and snakes. Rembrandt couldn't have captured that beauty. It's one of those mornings you feel like just running around barefoot.